Historically, lightning-caused wildfires burn more acres than human-caused wildfires. In 2018, we saw a shift. The number of human-caused wildfires and acres burned from these fires increased exponentially, and they have continued to increase ever since. Humans are now the leading cause of wildfires. The 10-year average indicates 87% of wildfires nationally are human-caused. While many of these wildfires are accidents, most of them can be prevented. What can you do to help the wildfire prevention effort? Let's take a look at how you as a first responder can help prevent human-caused fires just by the actions you take when responding to an incident. When you respond to the scene of a wildfire, there's a lot to consider. Safety zones, escape routes, protecting life and property, anchor points, resource needs, suppression tactics, risks and hazards. Are you thinking about the cause of the fire? Is it important? Yes, it is important for all responders to understand that you play a role in determining fire cause. Your actions at the scene can make or break a case. If we know what is causing fires, we can learn to prevent them. If the fire was set with criminal intent, such as arson, origin protection is key in making a solid case. The only way to determine the cause is through a thorough investigation, and that investigation starts with you. This brings us to origin protection and how you as a firefighter can help preserve vital evidence and note key scene observations.
Protecting the origin is important because to solve your investigation or your crime or how to figure out how it started, if you don't protect it, you're going to trample over evidence that could lead to a suspect or the potential cause might be hidden because it's got buried under debris or whatever. So it's important to protect it so that you can solve your investigation.
Sometimes when you arrive on scene, you know, you're trying to determine where you're going to start your suppression actions, what other resources are going to be on scene. But you also need to think about where that potential origin is. And if it's in an area where you need to get through there, need to get around it, to get to the fire, think about the least impact you can make on that potential origin. Avoid heavy suppression marks, avoid stomping through it, avoid trying to use your shovel through it. Anything that's going to disturb that origin is going to make it harder to determine the cause.
So we have to approach the investigation with our law enforcement hat on. Not all of us have a law enforcement background or have that experience. So if you don't, you know, get your local rangers or other county deputies to give you a hand or a state trooper or whoever that might be to assist you if you really believe that, you know, there's something malicious involved, there's intent, and you're looking at an arson fire, you need to bring in those law enforcement officers right away. A lot of fires are accidental. They're not meant to be malicious. There may not be intent, but there are some of those that fall in that category. So it's important that, you know, we work with our law enforcement division because we typically will see a higher success rate when we work cooperatively together on these cases.
Once the general origin area is properly protected, valuable evidence is protected. Valuable evidence, such as the ignition source, could be easily destroyed if not properly protected, leading to an undetermined cause. Even small items left at the scene, paper wrappers, cigarette butts, bottles, and cans, could provide forensic evidence that may lead to the identity of a suspect, if properly protected. When you're responding to a fire, add origin protection to your suppression tactics list, along with considering anchor points and resource needs. A component of protecting life and property is determining fire causes to prevent future damaging, catastrophic, and life-threatening fires. The only way to determine the cause is by conducting a thorough investigation. It is especially important to work with qualified Wildland Fire Investigators, or IMVFs, on every wildfire to determine cause and possibly the responsible party. Wildland Fire Investigators have the knowledge, skills, and tools needed to properly document the scene, locate the point of ignition, collect evidence, interview witnesses, and determine the cause, which could lead to identifying the responsible party. Fire investigators are also the ones who will be writing the official report, As a first responder, you have a responsibility to note observations of the scene and protect the origin area. By doing so, you are doing your part in cause determination. One step closer to determining fire cause brings us one step closer to preventing future fires. When you're responding to a fire, think about protecting the origin, especially if the wildfire is suspected to be human-caused.
You know, sometimes it's kind of hard to determine where the origin is, and until you actually get into the fire scene and start breaking down, and what we look at a lot is the burn pattern indicators, you're not going to have a lot of time to be looking at that. You can generally see what direction the fire is moving. If you have a large black area, probably somewhere in that large black area, that's your origin.
I encourage people to protect it by putting something on the perimeters, and maybe not a lot. Something that they can identify and say, hey, stay out between these two things. But they don't need to figure out exactly where it started. They just need to say, this is a general origin.
So one thing a firefighter, first responder has these days is generally a smartphone. If you can snap photos when you're coming into the scene, awesome. Even responding, you see a car coming out that maybe it's the only car in the area, get a picture of it. That way you have that picture, possibly the license plate number. Anytime you can get photos of anything when you first get on the scene, that's helpful too. What does the fire look like? Especially if the fire investigator isn't going to be there right away, they get a good idea of what it looks like when you arrived at the scene.
Some of the things that the first responders should definitely be looking for is sometimes evidence that is easily destroyed, like this tire track. Especially on a majority of our agency type roads that are graveled or dirt, these soft impressions can be easily destroyed by another tire track or a boot print or even the wind or rain sometimes. So if at all possible, if you have tire tracks in and around the heel of the fire or the origin of the fire, it's really important to not only protect the black, but those areas immediately surrounding the black. A majority of the time, we find a lot of evidence that's actually outside the perimeter of the fire.
When firefighters first arrive, as you notice, when we come down a road, a dirt road, you're looking for the tire tracks, obviously. Something that might be out of place, they may have pulled over, may have turned around, skidded out. Also looking for foot tracks that probably shouldn't be there, a gate that might be open, that should be closed. First responders, when they first arrive on scene, are also looking for probably that area that's already burned, obviously. And it might be a small area, but it could be a pretty large area. So think big when you're looking at protecting the origin, because you don't know, it could be multiple starts as well. So we're looking at potentially having a large area. And if you think that's the area where the fire started, make sure you flag it off, mark it somehow, let the other responders know that they're coming in, that this area is marked, what color flagging it's marked with, or whatever you have to mark it with, so people know to kind of stay out of that area until investigators arrive.
There are some things you can do to help with the fire investigation. The Incident Response Pocket Guide, or IRPG, has a checklist for you to follow to assist investigators with cause determination. In your IRPG, you'll find the Fire Origin Protection Checklist. This checklist provides a good outline to follow for anyone responding to an incident. Start by requesting a Wildland Fire Investigator or Law Enforcement Officer. Ensure a qualified fire investigator has been dispatched to the fire if it is suspected to be human-caused. The earlier they can get there, the better for scene and evidence preservation. Make notes of all your actions and findings. Identify and ask the responsible party and witnesses to remain on scene until fire investigator arrives. Note the name, contact information, and identification of the reporting party. Make en route observations. Include things like people or vehicles descriptions and smoke column color and direction. List the first resources on scene. Get the name and identification of persons or vehicles in vicinity of fire origin. If you can't get a name, get a good description. License plate numbers can provide a lot of useful information. Take weather observations, especially note wind shifts that change the direction the fire is burning, which could make it a little more difficult to identify the origin area. Locate and protect the fire origin. Preserve area. Do not contaminate the area of origin or evidence with trash or traffic. Watch where you step. Also keep in mind there could be multiple ignitions, which equal multiple origin areas. Avoid suppression impacts to the area of origin. Use a fog nozzle. Spray only where absolutely necessary, and make note of any suppression actions taken. Establish containment lines to protect the area. Knock down the fire burning around and outside the origin area. Avoid the origin area itself. Allow heavier fuels to burn down instead of trying to suppress that log or burning cow pie. Leave them. They shouldn't be a threat as they are contained within the origin area. Focus on securing the fire perimeter until the fire investigation is complete. Allow the fire investigators time to do their job. Protect physical evidence. Do not touch or remove it unless necessary to prevent destruction. If you do touch or move evidence, let the fire investigator know and note the original location if it was moved. If you're able to do so, take photos, including close-up views of the fire origin area and evidence. Turn over all notes, information, and physical evidence to the fire investigator or law enforcement officer. Make sure you follow local procedures and policy regarding reporting of cause information. Why is it important to have qualified Wildland Fire Investigators, INVFs?
When you're looking at a potential negligent set or criminally set, which is an intentional set fire, you're looking at bringing in law enforcement and you're looking at a possible litigation action, whether it's going to be criminal action or pursuing suppression costs. For those reasons, you need somebody qualified to be able to put the whole case together, basically, and recording that in document that's going to hold up in court.
Having qualified fire investigators respond to wildfire incidents will increase the likelihood of cost recovery, reveal patterns to determine future fire prevention measures, and identifying potential criminal activity. Was the ignition truly an accident, or was there negligence or criminal intent involved? A fire investigator can help law enforcement officials make that determination by helping build the case through their investigation. Wildland fire investigators can also provide a thorough report using the scientific method.
That'll come up in court time and time again. Did you follow the methodology? Did you follow the scientific method to come to your conclusion of what caused the fire?
Fire investigators, along with fire managers, rely on you as a first responder and firefighter to help with fire investigation. Have you ever thought of becoming a fire investigator? Or maybe you would just like to learn more? Talk to your local Wildland fire investigator and look for training near you. FI-110, Wildland Fire Observations and Origin Scene Protection for First Responders, is an introductory course that teaches sound wildland fire observation and origin scene protection practices. Check it out in the NWCG training catalog. If you're interested in going further and want to become a wildland fire investigator, talk to your supervisor or training officer about enrolling in FI-210, Wildland Fire Origin and Cause Determination class, and opening a position task book. Qualified INVFs are in high demand. It can be a rewarding and fun job, so consider it. Over the past several years, around 87% of all wildfires were determined to be human-caused. First responders play a critical role in protecting fire origin to help wildland fire investigators determine the cause. You can educate yourself using the IRPG Fire Origin Protection Checklist or by attending NWCG Fire Investigation courses. Stay safe out there and do your part to prevent wildfires. Assist in the fire investigation by making observations and protecting the origin area.